Good evening, everyone. My name's Chris Cooper, known as the Channel Guy Trader, and I'm reporting to you live from Wall Street Trading's Miami office down in sunny South Florida. Today's date is Tuesday, July the 30th, 2013, and here is today's After the Bell Market Summary video brought to you by WallStreetTrading.com. Before I get into the video here, I want to remind you guys, next month, August the 10th, we're hosting our Active Traders course at our Miami office down here in Coral Gables. If you're interested in finding out the details about that course, you can contact me at ccooper@wallstreettrading.com. If you're interested in finding out details on how you could join our prop firm and get licensed and become a professional trader, you can contact me at ccooper@wallstreettrading.com as well, and I'll be able to give you more details on that. If you haven't followed us on our Facebook page, go check it out. Same name, Wall Street Trading. We post a lot of intraday analysis on that page. We post a lot of the trades that we call out in our on our live chat room, which is mywallstreettv.com. A lot of good stuff going on, guys. You want to be a part of it, go ahead, join us on Facebook, join us on the chat room. You're more than welcome to do so, and you can just contact me if you have any questions. Aside from that, let's go ahead and get into this video here, starting off with this. Let's go ahead and see how the indices close the session here for the day. The Dow closed down a point, pretty much flat. The Nasdaq closed up 17 and a quarter or so, and the S&P 500 closed up a little over half a point. You take a look at the breadth on the market, pretty much a mixed day here. We had 3,107 issues advancing on the NYSE, Nasdaq, and the AMEX. We had 3,024 issues declining on the NYSE, Nasdaq, and the AMEX. Therefore, breadth was in favor of the bulls today, but pretty much kind of flat, a little bit in favor of the bulls, but you can say it's just about matched up there. Aside from that, a couple things we noticed today. The Nasdaq showed relative strength to the market, guys. If you have not checked out our midday market update to see how we nailed the move on the Nasdaq today, you can go ahead and check that, or you can check it out on our Facebook page. We posted the analysis before the market opened up, and we guided our traders on an intraday basis, reading the tape and everything, why the trade took place, and we did pretty well. Some traders used the futures, like I did. I traded the Nasdaq futures to participate in that move up. Some traders traded the triple Qs. Some traders were buying Apple and Facebook today. So a lot of good stuff going on, and we're going to show you how we do some of our analysis here if you guys have not had a chance to see some of our other videos here. So starting off with the SPY daily chart, the S&P 500 ETF, you can see we closed pretty much flat. Yeah, we closed flat. I mean, there was nothing too crazy today. We definitely had some decent action intraday. We had some stocks popping up left and right, but on the S&P 500, it was a quiet day. The Dow Jones had some action again, but most of the action was in the Nasdaq, folks. And if you were in the chat room, you would have been able to participate and catch on to that before everybody else did in the market moved up. But in any case here, 168 is going to be a key level that we're going to be watching on the SPY going into tomorrow's session. As you guys know, FOMC minutes are tomorrow. We have a lot of news coming out tomorrow. We actually have a lot of news coming out for the rest of the week that's going to be causing these markets to move pretty well. So you want to make sure you bring your A game like we said on Monday. Make sure you're patient. Make sure you take the right trades and you'll be fine. All right. As you can see, 168, the support level to watch. We break below 168. You want to watch last Friday's lows right here. That's right in front of 167. That happens to be at 167.5. We break below that. You want to watch the 167 level, which also lines up with these rising 20-day moving averages here, the exponential and the simple moving average around that 167.14 area. If we break over today's highs, you can expect us to hit this 169.81 level. It could come tomorrow if we make it to the top side. If the FOMC comes out and investors don't like what they hear, all right, then level you want to watch the downside is going to be this 167.40 area. Expecting some nice volatility tomorrow. Expect a nice little wide range bar tomorrow. We'll see how it plays out. Or we could still chop around. As you guys notice, we're still in this wide range right here. We're not even a wide range, but we're still in this little dollar and 80 cent range here, 167, 169.81 or so. And until we break out this range, you just want to make sure you take your trades, you know, with your risk management and everything on point. All right, folks. That's how the SPY is looking. Let's go ahead and take a look at the ES, the S&P 500 futures. Same thing here, trading sideways, flash down today. Dip buyers came back into the market right here around 2 o'clock and bought the market up until the close. We did have some nice selling pressure come in the market, though. on the S&P 500. Again, the S&P was the weakest index today until was the weakest index today in general. It just couldn't catch a bid. If you take a look at the 50-minute chart on the futures of the S&P via the SPY, you can see that we were having three up bars on the 50-minute chart, then two down bars, three up bars, and we sold off around 1 o'clock, and then we got a bounce at 2 o'clock. So dip buyers came back in the markets. And tomorrow, again, we're going to be looking for a nice day. Love what you want to watch in the S&P 500 futures, 169, I'm sorry, 1695 half. And then down here, the 1670 area. And then right now, the 1677 area has been coming into play the past 2 days or so. All right, so I would work off the 1677 for the short term. And then this key area we've been trying to break past around these 1688s, which have been giving us some trouble for the past couple sessions here. All right, we take a look at the Nasdaq via the triple Qs. Nasdaq, great day today, made new 52-week highs. Nasdaq looks like it has a lot of more has a lot of room to the top side. Again, we already broke past the 50% Fibonacci from the tech bubble sell-off. The 61.8 Fibonacci is around 82.37, which is what, 7 bucks higher or so. So we definitely have some more upside potential on the Nasdaq. If the markets were to break out, I would say you want to focus on the Nasdaq. All right, you could take a look at our Facebook page to see the analysis and why we were targeting the Nasdaq today as being the cleanest index to trade if you were trading indices, or the cleanest index to look for stocks that trade in that index so that you can participate with them on the upside. So either way, again, new 52-week highs. Everything looks good. We're above these moving averages. We should have some nice momentum coming in here. All right, had a nice little close higher than yesterday's price action. And if we break over 75.95, call it 76, we should be looking for more towards at least 76 half, 77, and we'll get some more levels going forward. If we break down below today's lows, we want to be looking for a move back down towards this key 75 level to back test this top of this little range that we broke out of on a Friday. We break below that, then you want to be working off of Friday's lows around the 74.50 area. All right, I want to show you guys my proprietary channel analysis on the NQ. You guys been watching the videos from before, you guys know that we called the Nasdaq for a breakout back here when we broke outside of this nice little channel that we had. I have highlighted here. Okay, we called that, and that was before the, you know, before CNBC and all, everybody on the whole media that goes on CNBC were talking about you want to be invested in technology stocks. We nailed it before then. They started talking about buying technology stocks, I would say, right here, or like 2 weeks later. And then we came back to the bottom of the channel. You see the bottom of the channel held back up, came back up to the top of the channel. We got rejected near the top of our resistance channel, and now we're kind of holding up near this key channel line right here. All right, this is some good stuff, guys. These channels are from over a year ago, maybe even 2 years ago, and it's crazy how the market is so symmetrical and these key trend lines are still in play. And it's like the price action is just filling the chart in itself. You know, the levels are there. If it respects it, you can play it off of. If it doesn't, you know, which you can just take the opposite trade. It's real helpful, and we trade off these channels on an intraday basis, guys. You want to come check the information out. A lot of good stuff going on here. Aside from that, looking for a move above the top here, this resistance channel. I have it highlighted red because it's actually a key level from before, more than a year ago. So we'll see. You can see it's supporting down here, and you can see it kind of looks like a little cup and handle pattern action going there. So we'll see how it plays out. The IWM was showing some weakness again today with the S&P. It did get a nice recovery around 2 o'clock, just like the other broad indices. But a couple of things you have to worry about. Had this little high up here that it's getting knocked up, knocked down against. And then we have the main support level from the breakout is down here at 99.50. All right, folks, broke out right there. So if we were to pull back, if we were to break below the 20 moving average and start filling in some of these gaps that we have in the chart, a back test area would be around 99.54, which lines up with that rising 50-day simple and exponential moving average. At the same time, right now, short-term support on the IWM is right down here at 103. We break below 103. You want to work off that 102.50 area, which lines up with the 20-day simple and exponential moving average. We break below that, you have this little 102 area to work against, and then we have a gap fill that's all the way down here, say around 101 and a quarter. So, but keep an eye on that 103 level. We take out today's highs. You're going to be working off of yesterday's highs around this 104.25 or so. We break above that, 104.50, then 105. So some decent levels to work off of on the IWM as well. Again, expecting a nice wide range bar in the broad indices tomorrow off of this FOMC minutes action that should be coming out tomorrow around 2:15, I believe. That's what else do I want to talk about here? Let's go ahead and take a look at the VIX. The volatility index did have a nice move today to the top side. It did come off the highs a bit there. You know, this thing's pretty weird because the VIX was going up and the VXX was just chopping around, not doing much. That's why I really don't like trading these ETFs that are, a lot of people say that are structured incorrectly. And for example, again, let me go ahead and show you guys a quick example. Let's take a look at a 15-minute chart here. All right, the VIX, VIX. All right, the VIX was in a nice little uptrend, moving up. All right, bottomed out at 10:30 and then rose the whole day, topped out at 145. Take a look at the VXX. Never did a pullback. The VXX sold off at 10:30. Popped up a little bit right here, but sold off at 10:30 and then sold off again at 145. On that time, I respected it, but it showed you this thing should have been trending up since 10:30 the whole time there. But just shows you why you got to be careful when you trade these ETFs. They don't trade like they're supposed to. But anyways, the VIX popped up, gave a lot of that action back. You know, again, those dip buys are still coming in the market, and until they stop coming in the market, you got to, you know, try to buy that dip as well with them and participate with the big boys that are making the easy money off the lows. All right, let's go ahead and take a look at the commodities here. I didn't get to go through the commodities with you over the weekend. I want to start off with crude oil, which has been pulling back lately. It's going to be coming into some nice support levels down here around 98, right? 98 was a breakout level from the resistance. Broke out right there. So that should be a nice area to back test for. Look for a back test hold if we were to pull all the way back down and move down $5 from here. If not, 100, 150 would be a decent area to try to scalp it against and see if it wants to put a higher pivot low, try to move back up. You could go ahead and draw this little key trend line in there and use that as a gauge. You have a nice little tight downward channel that's setting up right now. Crude oil is trading in this nice little downward tight channel, I should say. Let's go ahead and take a look at gold. All right, gold was showing a nice little bid last week. Haven't really been following up on it this week. I'm pretty sure it's going to get a nice little move tomorrow. As you guys know, we've been talking about gold moving up to back test that area from the inverted cup and handle pattern. All right, that happened once it broke past this 1300 level. It got that nice momentum that picked in for a little bit, but then it got halted right there, right at 1350. Now it's consolidating between 1350 and this 1300 level. A break and hold above 1350 should take us up back up to this level right here from the handle of the inverted cup, which is around 1411. Again, if you guys have been watching these videos, you guys will know that we were looking at that action for a back test. Again, make sure you subscribe to the videos, share the videos. Have a lot of good stuff going on here, guys, and it's only going to get better. GDX, gold miners. Let's go ahead and take a look at this sector, see what the sector's been doing here. Gold miners chopping around now after making this little choppy move up. Not really the sector that I would want to be trading. All right, some key stocks that are moving right now. Let's go ahead and take a look at some key movers and shakers. Apple, all right, this one holding above 420. It held above its gap open from the earnings right there. And it's been moving higher since with some nice momentum behind it. All right, this has been a big factor, of course, in helping the NASDAQ move up because there's a 12% weighting in the triple Qs of Apple. Okay. Microsoft had a nice little move up today. All right, was up close to 1%. Came in a little bit off of the highs, but, you know, it's gotten crushed from that earnings report. Held a nice little bid down here around 31, and now it's trying to pick back up to the top side. What else we have going on here? Some action in the solars. FSLR had a nice little move up today. Up 2.5%. Looks like it's getting ready to move back to the top side a bit. They do have earnings coming out on the next month on the 6th. So keep an eye on that. Amgen, they had a nice little move up today. They were up close to 2%. Had earnings come out this morning. If I'm not mistaken, earnings or after the close. Let me see here. They had earnings after the close. Let me see how they traded. Oh, and they sold off. All right, so Amgen's going to be in play tomorrow. Keep that one on your radar. That one sold off. Facebook. All right, Facebook, we called this one out in our chat room for long at 30 6, and look what it went today. It went to 38. Nice strong move there. If you take a look at the 15-minute chart, right, it gave you a nice little tight pattern to get long against. Actually, the 5-minute chart, excuse me here. Gave you a nice little low-risk entry right here on the 5-minute chart, guys. Over the high, put a stop at this bar. They did a little bit of shakeout right there, but once it got over that 36 level, this thing just took off pretty clean. Nice clean move there. Another some stocks that are setting up, and I think technology stocks are going to outperform this quarter, so I'm focusing on some of these stocks here, but take a look at CRM. All right, held a nice little bid down here around 42. Nice little U-shaped pattern right here. Finally breaking a whole new above this 43 bid. Next target on the stock looks to be back up here towards these highs around 47. All right, so keep this stock on your radar. Looks pretty good. Let's go ahead and take a look at the financials. The financials, if I'm not mistaken, they were weak yesterday. They were weak yesterday, and they came in a little bit more today. Again, this may be some sector rotation going on. Some money coming out of the financials, some profit taking, and rotating into some of these technology stocks that are shaping up to move up to the top side. Take a look at Sprint. Sprint's highlighted here on the screen. Sprint had a nice little move up today. We don't trade these cheap stocks, but again, they had a nice little move up from the earnings report. What else, folks? Let me take a look at some more stuff here. Again, we were focused mostly on Facebook, Apple, and we mostly trade the Qs today, just a general broad indices. Just a general market there. We were trading the ES and the NASDAQ. But, yeah, that's about it right now, guys. I definitely have some more stuff on watch for tomorrow. But I'm liking the action in the technology stocks. The market action looks pretty good. Take a look at Cisco. Cisco over 26 will look pretty good for tomorrow. It did have a little pullback off the highs, but still looks like it's in great shape. Let me take a look at Google real quick. Let's see here. Google holding 880. Resistance right there around 928. Some of these Chinese stocks been in play. Baidu had a nice little move up today. All right, look for Baidu to try to break out over this 133 area. I'll be watching this one tomorrow. If Baidu looking like it's going to move to the top side, you want to make sure you take a look at Sina and Sohu, some of these other Chinese stocks. Sina looking pretty good. Nice breakout if it takes out 68. Sohu, let's see what this one's doing here. Sohu, not quite much. Looks like they're still having some negative sentiment from their earnings report. By the way, those are some good stocks to watch, guys. Keep them on watch. Hope you guys had a great day today. Make sure you check out the website. All right, well, 1 second. I want to go through the agriculture sector because those stocks were in play today. Mosaic. All these stocks had a nice little move off the lows. Look at Mosaic. Got down to 40, brought it up all the way back to 43. Keep an eye on those names going forward as well. I posted the news on the Facebook page if you want to know why they all gapped down this morning. Potash moved down. CF had a big move yesterday. This one, you can see open lower, rally all the way back up and sold off. Wow, that's some crazy action right there. Let's take a look at the 5-minute. Yeah. Definitely some decent opportunities here in this market, guys. You want to make sure you're in the right names, and you could do pretty well on an intraday basis. It's some decent trading out there. Aside from that, have a great day, guys. I'll catch you guys tomorrow morning. Make sure you check out the chat room, mywallstreettv.com, to get access to that chat room. Contact me at ccooper@wallstreettrading.com. If you're interested in our active traders course, send me an email. And if you're interested in finding out how you can get licensed to become a professional trader with our firm, contact me as well. Have a great day, folks. Cheers.